In this session, I'll be going to explain mathematics, which is there behind Smith chart. Now, as we know, Smith chart, that is extremely useful tool for engineers who are designing RF circuit and microwave circuit. So this video covers mathematics behind Smith chart and its physical interpretation. Usually people are using Smith chart since 1930, and they are exactly manipulating understanding of their circuits in Smith chart. So before you start with RF engineering or microwave engineering, I think this video is so useful to anybody who is actually concerned with Smith chart. So in this session, I'll be explaining exact understanding how Smith chart have been plotted, what is the understanding of it, and then by using this little mathematics, you can understand how this complete Smith chart is functioning. So let us begin this session. Now, in microwave, as we all know, reflection coefficient that is, if I say it is rho, and that is ZL minus Z0 divided by ZL plus Z0. And in this reflection coefficient, if I normalize this, then it will be ZL by Z0 minus 1 divided by ZL by Z0 plus 1. Now usually what we do is we point out load impedance normalizedly in Smith chart. So I'll be considering normalized impedance over here. So for that, if I say this ZL, which is what normalized ZL with respect to characteristic impedance. So that is ZL divided by Z0. So my reflection coefficient now, that will be ZL minus 1 divided by ZL plus 1. Now, as we know, this load impedance, that is having resistive part as well as reactive part. So ultimately, I can say this ZL, that could be R plus JX, where R, that is what resistive part, and X, that is what reactive part. In case of inductive element, this X will be positive. In case of capacitive element, X will be negative. So this is what resistive element, and this is reactive element. And for inductive, X is positive, and for capacitive, this X, that is negative. So this is what the basics that we already know. Now let us begin how this Smith chart is getting plotted based on this understanding. So let us place ZL value in this. So after placing ZL value over here, now my reflection coefficient, that will be R plus JXL minus 1 divided by R plus JX plus 1. Let us rearrange this. So this will be R minus 1 plus JX divided by R plus 1 plus JX. Now here, my goal is to separate out real and imaginary part. So what I'll be doing is, I'll be multiplying complex conjugate of denominator. So if I multiply and divide with R plus 1 minus JX and R plus 1 minus JX with this, then I'll be able to separate out real and imaginary part. So let us separate it out. So if we multiply that in denominator, you'll be having r plus 1 square plus x square, and in numerator if you multiply this, there will be real as well as imaginary part, and real part that you can have, which is r square plus x square minus 1, and imaginary part that will be plus j into 2x. So this is what you will get once you separate out real and imaginary from numerator. In denominator it will be this r plus 1 whole square plus x square. Now let us say this is what real part, so let us take it separately. So r plus x square minus 1 divided by r plus 1 whole square plus x square, this is real part, and plus j into 2x divided by r plus 1 whole square plus x square. So this is how you have real and imaginary part over here. Now here if I say I have a reflection coefficient and that is having two parts, that is what I can easily see. Let us consider this is what a plus jb. So here I can say one equation that I have which is based on real, that is what a is equals to r square plus x square minus 1 divided by r plus 1 whole square plus x square. And here for imaginary I have b, and that is now 2x divided by r plus 1 whole square plus x square. Now remember this, here this a that is there with real and this b that is there with imaginary. So this is what we need to consider. The reason is this is what we have considered already. Generally what happens is when you draw circles you forget that, like, see, a is for real and b is for imaginary. Now let us move further. If I say this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. Now here what we can do is, like, see, by using equation 1 and equation 2 I can solve two unknowns. Here if I say unknowns are x and r. So here x and r are unknown. So ultimately what I will be doing is I will be solving x and r. So here two equations are there and two unknowns are there. So if we solve these two equations, we will be having unknown quantities. So that is, let us say x. So if you solve these two equations, you will be finding x square, and that is a into r plus 1 whole square minus r square plus 1 and divided by 1 minus a. And if you solve this for r, then you will be having resistive part, and that resistive part square, let us say it is r only, so r will be square root of minus bx into bx minus 2 minus b divided by b. So this is what the solution that you can have after having solution of this two equation. Now this is little difficult to solve, but you can practice at your home. You will definitely get this solution of r and x based on these two equations. This is just a solution of two equations. My concern is to explain what is the physical understanding based on mathematics of Smith chart. So I am just taking it directly right now. Now if I say this is equation 3 and if I say this is equation 4, then what I'll be doing is, like, see, I'll be placing value of x in equation 2. So if I place value of equation 3 into 2 and value of equation 4 into 1, then I'll be having two equations, which are the equations for circles. So let us have it. So by placing 3 into 2, I'll be having one equation, that is a minus r divided by r plus 1 whole square plus b square is equals to 1 divided by r plus 1 whole square. And here, if I place value of equation 4 in equation 1, then I'll be having second equation. So by placing 4 into 1, my another equation, that will be a minus 1 whole square plus b minus 1 by x whole square, and that is equals to 1 by x square. So that is how I'll be having two equations. Now this is very interesting. If you see these two equations, so these are the equations of circles. Now see here, we can say this equation, that is having center, and that is at r divided by r plus 1, and this coordinate is 0, y coordinate is 0. And if I say radius, so that radius, if I say that is r1, so which is exactly 1 by r plus 1. And this is what the equation, which is what we are having for real part. So real circles, this is having center, which is what, r divided by r plus 1. So this is real circles, which is what you are finding it in Smith chart. And if you see this equation, so which is having center at 1 comma 1 by x, and its radius is r2, which is what, 1 by x. So this equation, that is equations of circle with center 1 by 1 comma 1 by x and radius is 1 by x. So these are the circles which are imaginary circles. So these are the circles which are imaginary circles. Now let us plot it and try to understand what is that which is happening inside. And then after, we'll see step by step how many things are there with this Smith chart. So this is very interesting. You will find it more interesting after observing this video. Here it is not only about derivation and mathematics, but what happens is people are just thinking this is just a Smith chart, but one should understand, like, see what are the things which is there with this. So let us try to understand that by these equations. So as I have derived those equations for real and imaginary, now I'll be plotting those circles so that one can understand. Let us say this is what one axis, which is what I'm drawing, and I'm considering this point. And if I say this point is 1 comma 0, if I say this point is 1 comma 0. Now let us try to understand circles. So here, see, this is the circle which is having real value. And in general circuit, as I have told, impedance, that is having two parts, resistive parts and reactive parts. So resistive part, that is always positive. That is what we are considering when we plot Smith chart. So this is resistive part, which is what, R, and that is having real value. So if I say I have R in this equation and that is having real value, so these circles, those are these circles. So these circles are real circles, and when we say these are real circles, that is having center, which is what I have derived. Center is at r divided by r plus 1 comma 0, and radius, if I say it is r1, so that is 1 divided by r plus 1. This is what I have derived already. So these are these circles. Now when I say what is that which is there with these imaginary circles, so here imaginary circles, that is having two things, either that x could be positive, that x could be negative. X will be positive in case of reactance is inductive reactance, and x will be negative in case of reactance is capacitive reactance. So it is possible x could be positive, x could be negative. So if I place positive value, you will be finding plotting of this circle that will emerge from here, and it will go like this. And one can see for negative circles x, so it will be these circles. So for negative x, you will be finding these are these circles. So if I say what is that which is there with center of these circles, so center of this circle, that is at 1 comma 1 by x, and its radius, if I say it is r2, then that will be 1 by x. So that is how these circles are there. Now our case is very interesting. Like, see, now everybody got, like, see how those circles are there, right? So what I'll be doing is, like, I'll be taking few cases which will explain you how things are there on this Smith chart. So let us have those cases. So I'll be considering first case. So let us consider first of all first case, and then I'll place things over there. So I'm taking case one, where what I take is, like, see, R and X are infinite. So if R and X, those are infinite, then what will happen? So as we have two circles, one is real circle, so real circle, that is at center with 1 by 1 comma 1 by x, and radius, sorry, this is imaginary circle, and radius r2, that is 1 by x, right? And real circles, that is having center at r by r plus 1 comma 0, and radius is 1 by r plus 1. So its radius is 1 by r plus 1, and center, that is at r divided by r plus 1 comma 0, and radius r1, that I have said, which is what, 1 by r plus 1. Now over here, if I take r and x to be infinite, so what happens? So if I take r and x, both are infinite, this circle, that will become 1 comma 0, and you can see radius, that will be 0. So r2, now that will be 0. And if I place r as an infinite, so take r common from numerator and denominator, so this will become 1 divided by 1 plus 1 by r, and 1 by r is 0 in case of r is infinite. So you'll be finding it is 1 divided by 1 plus 0, so that is what, exactly 1. So one can say this is what, 1, and this is 0. And if I place r is infinite, so this is what, 1 by infinite, and in that case r1 will be even 0. So what happens is, in case of r and x, both are infinite, circles are getting converged at 1 comma 0, and circles are getting converged at 1, 0. Converge means radius are 0 and both circles are getting focused at point which is what? 1, 0. So in this case here circles, both circles, real and imaginary circles are converged at 1, 0. So one can easily say this is what this point, which is what the reference point from where we are beginning our Smith chart. So here these circles are getting converged in case of R and X are infinite. Now let us consider few more interesting case. So now I'll be taking second case. What if R is equals to 0? So if R is equals to 0, here we have already, I have written imaginary circles. So these are at 1, 1 by x and its radius is 1 by x, and real circle, these are with center r by r plus 1, 0 and radius r1, that is 1 by r plus 1. Now if real part is 0, so in that case over here what will happen to this real circle, we'll be finding this is what getting 0. So now real circle's radius, that will be 1, and this part, that will be 0. So center of that will be 0, 0, and radius, that will be r1 is equals to 1. So that is what the case which is happening right now. So here one can say what is happening over here is, in our Smith chart, this circle which is at center 0, 0 and radius is 1, that is what boundary of Smith chart. So ultimately the circle which is what I have plotted over here, that is what most outward circle of Smith chart. This is what most outward circle of Smith chart, and that is having center over here, which is what 0, 0, and this circle, that is what boundary of Smith chart, and you can say it is having center at 0, 0 and radius r1 is boundary of Smith chart. So ultimately when we place r is equals to 0, that is what resulting most outward circle of real, and that is what boundary of Smith chart. So let us write it so that that note is getting complete. So it is boundary of Smith chart. So this is what boundary of Smith chart. Now let us have few more interesting cases. What if x is equals to 0? So now next case, that is what third case, if x is equals to 0. So if x is equals to 0, what will happen? So as I have written this equation for imaginary circle, so that imaginary circle, that is having center at 1 by 1, x and radius is 1 by x. So if I place x is equals to 0, now this circle that is having center at 1, infinite and radius, that you can see it is what, even infinite. So what is that? It is what real axis. Radius is infinite and point is 1, infinite. So ultimately one can easily see this is what real axis. So in Smith chart, which is what I have shown over here, this is real axis. In Smith chart, this is what real axis. So what is this real axis? it is actually a circle. Real axis, that is actually a circle, but it is axis because of radius is infinite. So ultimately you can say this line, that is what, 1, infinite, and radius r2, that is infinite. So this is what real axis of Smith chart, and that is what actually a circle. The reason is here its radius is infinite. So that is how it is there. So one should know, like, see, what is this exactly? So many engineers are using Smith chart, but they don't find it. What is this real axis and what is the boundary of Smith chart and those things. So to understand exactly what is that which is happening inside, I think these equations are very helpful to everybody. Now, let us move on to one more case that is very interesting. Like, if I say, what if r is less than 0? So if r is less than 0, there is no such standard Smith chart which can point out what is happening. So ultimately, if r is 0, no Smith chart can indicate what is happening. No Smith chart. Can do anything. But one can say some oscillations are happening. So if r is negative, one can say some oscillations are happening, and this is what people are using that in metamaterial. So in metamaterial, what we do is, like, see, we try to get it to negative resistance. And where we don't have any plotting with respect to Smith chart, the reason is it is not getting plotted on Smith chart. So one can say, like, see, it suggests oscillation. Which kind of oscillation, that even I cannot characterize right now. That we need to see physically by having some experiments. But we cannot say, like, what is happening. And you can say, like, see, this is what out of boundary of this complete Smith chart. So this is a Smith chart which is having r is positive and real and imaginary part, those are there, where r is positive and x could be positive or negative. That is what you can plot over here. But if r is negative, we cannot plot anything in this Smith chart. And the last one, which is what I would like to explain, that is how to plot. So this case explains how to plot. So one can understand, like, to have a plotting, this R, that is real circles. So magnitude of real circle, that you need to identify. And this X, that is imaginary circles. Imaginary is having positive, that is what, upper circles. And negative, that is lower circles. So that is how one can plot. Now in next session, I'll be discussing how to use Smith chart to plot out impedance, to plot out admittance, to calculate VSWR, and to have a calculation of reflection coefficient. So next session will be very interesting, where I'll be going to discuss how to have a calculation of all those parameters, like VSWR, reflection coefficient, and then one can calculate admittance as well as inductance. So admittance and impedance, those are very interesting thing, which is what we can understand based on Smith chart. So this is what the case which is there with next session. So stay tuned with this. I'll be explaining that in next session. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel. My basic agenda is to motivate electronic students or electronics people to go for RF. The reason is, in RF and microwave, one can earn as many as it is not possible for any other engineering. Thank you so much for watching this video.